Hi everyone, myself C. Maithili, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce CA, KSR College of Arts and Science for Women, Tirchangur. Communication is nothing but transferring information from one person to another person is called the communications. In communication process involves one sender, message and a recipient. It means by which different persons are linked together in a group or organization to attain a common goal. So communication is an exchange of facts, ideas, opinions or emotions by two or more persons. Meaning of communications. First one is information. Information is the main objective of communications. So it is passing or receive information about a particular fact or circumstances. Second one is advice. Advice is one type of communications. So the person either to influence his opinion or his behavior. The next one is order. So order is absolutely necessary for any organization irrespective of size, nature. So we follow the order of communications. Then succession. So the term succession means proposing something for acceptance or rejection. So it is way succession or ideas. So next one is education. So education involves conveying instructions, character building, giving training to human beings and so on. Next objective is persuasion. So it is inducing, compelling or promoting a person to act mostly in a positive way is known as the persuasions. Then warning. So warning is a forceful means of communications. So it may be oral or written. For example, no smoking, beware of dogs, dangers, etc. The next objective is counseling. So counseling is done by a man of greater skill or knowledge on some specific subject and he offers his counsel without any personal advice. Next, appreciations. Praising of initiative, good effort is known as appreciations. So it is very useful for creating a good attitude. Then last one is moral boosting. So moral refers to the team spirit and cooperation of people for a common purpose. Next we go to see nature or futures of communications. There are three futures are involved in the communications. First one is communication is an exchange of ideas. So we already told communications is nothing but an sharing information from one people to another peoples. So in the way communication is the process through which an exchange of information takes place. So it is sharing information, ideas, concepts and messages. So two or more parties involved in it communications. So information takes place between two or more persons. So then third nature is a two-way process because the two persons involved in communications. So these are the features of communications. Next, elements or process or steps of communications. So different processes are involved in the elements of communications. First, sender. Sender or the communicator generate the message and convey it to the receiver. Encoding. It is the act of translating the message into words, pictures, symbols or signs for some other form. Message. Message is the subject matter of communications. It may contain idea, information, view, fact, feeling, etc. Channel. It is the manner in which the encoded message is transmitting. So channel is nothing but again the message is transmitted to the another way. So that is it may be oral or written format. Then decoding. So it is process of converting the symbols encoded by the sender. So after decoding message is received by the receiver. So receiver. Receiver is a person who is the lost in the chain. So in for whom the message was sent by the sender. Next, feedback. So once the receiver confirms to the sender that has received the message and understood it. So this is the process completed in the feedback. Next, noise. So noise is an obstruction. So it is created in transmitting the message. So in the noise is created between the sender and receiver. For example, bad telephone connections, who are understanding of message due to prejudice or inappropriate gestures, etc. So these are the chart in the process of communication. Next, importance of communications. So first importance is helps in increasing productivity. So the effective business communication increase the productivity of stock by boosting up the teamwork, helps in increasing customers. So customers are the important in business, because customers is the king of the market. So we clearly define the communications to the customers. So it automatically attracting the new customers and retaining the current customers. Then third one is enhances business partnership. So the business communications also improve the partnership in the business. So it is plays a significant role dealing with external business clients or vendors. Fourth one is facilitates innovations in business. So effective business communications helps in business innovations, as well as it facilitates employees to convey their ideas and suggestions openly to the management. Fifth one is information exchange. So business communication is recorded by an organization for exchanging information with both internal and external stakeholders. So this helps in achieving its goals effectively. Sixth one is preparation of plans and policies. Through effective business communications, the organization make their plans and policies effectively and properly. So the relevant information is required for preparing both plans and policies. Seventh one is execution or implementation of plans and policies. To implement or execute the prepared policies and plans in a timely manner, so the manager should communicate the subordinates in a proper time, so the goals and policies are achieved in the organizations. Then eighth one is goals achievement. So through effective business communications, the employees become attentive and productive in doing their jobs. So that result in timely accomplishment of their tasks, and easily we attain the goals in the organizations. Kinds or types of communications. The types on the basis of organization structure and on the basis of media used. The organization structure further classified into two types, that is formal communications and informal communications. So formal communication is nothing but in the communication in a formal manner. So it has a formal structure in the organizational structure based communications. So formal communications further classified into three types, that is downward, upward and horizontal. Downward communication is meant top to bottom. So that is superior, supervisors, then subordinates. So the superior can give the instructions to the subordinates, can follow the downward communications. Next, upward communications. Upward communications is nothing but here bottom to top. So that is the subordinates hand give their opinions or views to the top managements. So subordinates, supervisor, then superior or managers. Then horizontal. So horizontal is nothing but the communications can flow in the horizontal line. So the information sharing between the two different heads. So that is the horizontal communications. So informal communications. Informal communications is nothing but an, so it is not an official manner. So it is not based a fixed structure. So informal communication, it may be grapevine communications. There is no specific channels in informal communications. For example, social media, WhatsApp, SMS are the examples of informal communications. Then next, media used. So the oral communications, written communication, non-verbal communications, audio visual communications. The oral communications furtherly divided into face-to-face communications, mechanical device for oral communications. Face-to-face communication is nothing but the place between two individuals or among small groups of persons. For example, meeting, conference, interview are the examples of face-to-face communications. then mechanic devices for oral communications, signal, telephone calls, dictating machines, speaking tubes or the mechanical device used for in the oral communications. Second one is written communications. Written communication is nothing but the communication in a written format for like memo, notice, telegram, reports, etc. Then non-verbal communications. Non-verbal communications means the communication is not communicated in a verbal form. So that is non-verbal communications. It may be unwritten or unspoken. For example, smiling, body movement, physical appearance, voice clearance. So that is the non-verbal communications. Then audio-visual communications. Audio-visual communications is nothing but then communication is transferred in a seen and heard. For example, watching TV, watching movies, watching news are the audio-visual communications. Next, barriers of communications. So first is semantic barriers. So semantic barriers means the words have the different meanings. So symbols with different meanings. A word can have different meanings in different contexts. So it is a wrong perception leads the communication problems. Then badly expressed message. So it may happen on account of omission of needed words, inadequate vocabulary, usage of wrong words. So it's also barriers of communications. Unqualified assumptions. So certain assumptions of the communications are subject to different interpretations. Then technical jargon. Sometimes the people may not understand the actual meaning of the technical jargon or language. So some specialists use the difficult language or critical word. So the receiver does not understand the communications. Then faulty translations. So sometimes mistakes may creep if a translator who is not proficient in English or Hindi, so it's not familiar, is not able to speak in English or Hindi, that time the faulty translations arise. So it is one of the barriers of communications. Then body language and gesture decoding. Communications may be wrongly perceived if there is no match between the what is said and what is expressed in body movements. Second one is physical or emotional barriers. So premature evaluations. The receiver preconceived the notions of the communications. He evaluate before the sender complete the message. Then loss by transmission and poor retention. So successive transmission of the messages results in inaccurate informations. So usually people cannot retain the information for long time in their mind. So it is inattentive and not interested. So it is one of the barriers of communications. Then lack of attention. So non-listening the message due to preoccupied mind of the receiver. So act as the major psychological barrier. Third one is organizational barriers. So first, organizational policy. So effectiveness of communication may be hampered in organizational policy is not supported to free flow of communications. The organizational policy also affect the communications. Status. Yes, status nothing but conscious manager may not allow his subordinates to express their feelings freely. So it is one of the organizational barriers. So it's affect the communications. Then rules and regulations. So difficult rules and regulations may hurdle the communications. Complexity in organization structure. So communication gets delayed and distorted if there are number of managerial levels in an organizations. Then organizational facilities. Communications may be hampered or may be affected if facilities for smooth and timely communications not provide. So the organization, the manager does not provide the communications, is not timely or is not clear means. So it is one of the organizational barriers. Then personal barriers. So fear of challenge to authority. A superior may withhold or does not say the information to the subordinates. So it is the fear of challenge to authority. Then lack of confidence of superior on his subordinates. Some superiors may not seek advice or opinions of their subordinates. So it is one of the personal barriers. Then unwillingness to communicate. So subordinates, they are willing to communicate their superior means. So it is the personal barriers. Then lack of proper incentives. The organization does not have any incentives or does not motivate the workers means it is one of the personal barriers in communication. Next, physical barriers. Distance, the two persons is maintained the long distance means the communication is reached not clearly. So the voice not clearly means the persons cannot receive the information in a correct manner. Then lack of time. So the superior is very much busy, so he will not have time to meet his subordinates, so due to lack of time. Then noise. So too much of noise also affect the communications. Is not able to hear the news or hear the views or hear the ideas or opinions in the communications. Then external disruptions. So high temperatures, high humidity, so the weather conditions also affect the communication. Then organizational blocks. So two persons in different organization cannot contact each other whenever they want. So these are the physical barriers and barriers of communications. Next we see modern communications methods. The different modern communication methods are there. So social media, direct message, instant message, SMS, text messaging, email marketing, direct email, blogging, voice calling, video chat, video marketing, live web chat, virtual reality. So these are the modern communication methods. So today technology is updated. So latest technology create the maximum modern communication methods. So it is effectively we communicate the information from one person to another person. Next, business letters or business correspondence. The business letter is also called as business correspondence. So business correspondence means exchange of business ideas, opinions or under discussions in a written form. So business letters nothing but here we are sharing information, ideas or opinion in a written form. So that is called the business letter. So need and the importance of business letters. So the business letter is most important in the organizations. So it is an inexpensive substitute for a personal visits. So the person not directly go to visit one company or one organization. So instead of this business letters is much useful to the organization. So it is an inexpensive substitute for a personal visit. Then it provide information on subjects connected with the business. So it's a micro level substitute. Even for advertisements also the business letter we can used. Then it provides valuable evidence for a transaction and that serves a legal purpose. Then it becomes a reference material. So it's a reference material to your future transaction between the organizations of individuals. So it promotes and sustains goodwill of the organizations. So it motivates all the people involved in the business higher and better level of performance. Next, functions of the business letters. The first function is promotional functions or sales functions. So it to grow and enlarge, improving the quality on their products, the business letter is very important. So by producing new products and providing better services, thus through business letters the customers have to be kept informed about the developments of the products or developments of the organizations. Then second one is informational functions or reference functions. The business letter can provide evidence in legal disputes that occur in a transactions. So they are useful as a legal documents in quotations and offers, etc. Then legal functions. So business letters provide valuable data about earlier policies, transactions and all other activities of the organizations. The letters are valid records for ready reference in the routine of administrations. Then goodwill function. Business letters promote goodwill among parties transacting the business. So they build a good relationship between your parties in a transaction. Next, kinds of business letters. So there are different kinds of business letters are involved in the communications. Then first one is letters of inquiry. So they are seeking information about the required grades and replies. Then offers and acceptance, orders and their execution, credit and status inquiry, claims or adjustments, collection letter, circular letter, sales letter, bank correspondence, insurance correspondence, agency correspondence, transport correspondence, secretarial correspondence and so on. Next, essential qualities of a business letters. So the mainly two qualities are needed to a business letters. The first one is inner quality. So it refers to the quality of language used and the presentation of your business letters. They are, it should be clear, it should be simple, it should be concise and concrete, it should be accuracy, send and concurrent, it should be complete, relevance, courteous and neatness for the related information in the business letter. Then outer qualities. The outer quality of a business letter means the qualities of outer appearance. So it look catchy and impressive in the business letter. So size of the paper, we should use the standard size of paper. Then quality of paper, so we should use the standard quality of paper, so like bond papers. Then color of paper, so mostly we used white color is the organization, it improve the organization's quality. Then folding of letters, the letter is folding is minimum folding involved in the letter. Then envelope, so envelopes is important for the business letter. So all the qualities are most needed to a effective business letter. Then components of a business letter or layout of a business letters. So the business letter have the different components or different layouts like headings, date, inside outers, attention line, salutation, subject and reference, body or substance of the letter, complimentary clause, signature, identification marks and enclosures. So these are the components must include in a business letter in a proper and systematic manner. So this is the layout of the business letter. So first we use the sender's address, then recipient's address, then date, month and year, then salutation. So it gives the greetings to the receiver. So then subject line, so what is the main subject in the business letters. Then body of the letter, what are the main contacts you are involved in the business letters. Then complimentary clause, so at the end of the letter we should use the complimentary clause. For example, yours sincerely, so yours obediently, so yours heartily, so that is the complimentary clause. Then signature, so signature should not typed, so the person can put the signature in a pen. Then position in the form, so what are the persons, what are the position in the form. Then enclosement, any additional document you should enclose in the letter means should enclosure also used. So these are the business letter layout followed in the business or organizations. So these are the points are included in the business communications. So thank you to all for watching. Thank you.